Hey everybody, I am going to show you the October releases for Everyday Explorers Company, and I am super excited to be working with all the stamp releases and also one from Life Story Market, which is a creative team member, Felicia Tess. She has a stamp set this month and it is Everyday Greenery. This is gonna have so many possibilities. I can see it in my creative journal. I can see it in my project life, all over the place. So like I said, there is four stamp sets, one from Felicia Tess, Everyday Greenery, and then this one is called Epic Fail Prompts. There is 29 prompts, I believe, on here, and it's all about the bad stuff or the bad day. So it's a no from me, burn it all down, today was hard, heck no, this is driving me crazy, hot mess, total disaster. It's gonna be perfect for documenting all the rough days. And then this one is all about introvert and extrovert, and it is called Amnivert Life, and it has fun phrases to document being an introvert and an extrovert, like quiet time is the best time, quiet please, tell me everything, current energy level, introvert mode, my favorite people. So lots of different phrases too. And then this one is so much gratitude. I absolutely love these big words right here. It's all about being grateful, giving thanks. So there's thankful for quality time. Oh, so I'm so feeling, just little phrases to kind of prompt you in your projects. For this video, I am going to do some projects in my journal from Persnickety Prints, kind of the COVID journal, but I use this more to document the aspects of my life starting from March all the way through May. Also for this journal, I take a lot of my stories from Instagram stories. So this one I just screenshotted and then I was able to print it. And when you screenshot from Instagram, it actually is a big resolution. So it comes out really big and you can shrink it down to any size. So that's pretty cool that it comes in a big size. So I have this one hiding in the kitchen, having some cookies, and I'm gonna use the Epic Fail stamp set on this one. And then this one is gonna start May and I'm gonna go crazy with all the greenery stamping. I may do it on a separate piece of paper. And I also pulled out this piece of vellum over here to maybe use and document from the aspect of how life was going into the third month of being home and limited activities. All right, I'm gonna get started on putting these pages together.
I'm going to start off by pulling off some stamps that I think will work for this design. I think I'm just going to go with all black ink. That was my initial thought, but then I thought, why don't I just do a rainbow design? So that's what I'm doing. And initially I had the photo on the right hand side, but at the last minute I decided, you know what, it should be on the left. And I'm really glad I made that decision because it made much more sense to be on the left. And then just down the side, I'm gonna do a rainbow stamping. I'm adding in some black dots just to give, I don't know, a little visual contrast and kind of a base foundation for my rainbow of stamped sentiments. I decided instead of trying to stamp on the actual notebook, I am just gonna stamp on this paper that I like, and then I will just fussy cut everything out. I didn't want to wind up messing up the sentiments and the journals. I don't know. I just didn't want to mess with it. So I'm going to go ahead and stamp a few phrases, and then I will fussy cut them all out, like I said. And because I have a hard time deciding which sentiment I like or which, I don't know. I just like to stamp multiple times. That way I can pick which image is the most crisp. I guess I'm getting more picky about my stamped images. I tried to edit out a lot of the fussy cutting. That way you guys didn't have to see that because I know that's boring. But for the phrases that I picked current energy level, quiet please, personal space, all I want to do is be by myself. The little circle one says something similar to like that, and then hot mess, and basically any phrase I could think of because I was literally hiding in the kitchen from my kids. Yes, they found me 2 minutes later, but I still snuck some soda and a cookie. It was just one of those days. There's a lot of those days now that we're stuck at home, I guess. There's also in the greenery kit, not greenery kit, the greenery stamp set from Felicia Chess, there is a really cool label, and so that's what I stamped right there. And then I put introvert mode and stamped it on top. But I didn't like how it came out, and so I stamped a second one and glued that one on top. I know, I'm getting way too picky with my sentiments and my stamping. I guess I'm becoming a true stamper. Okay, so I am going to stamp just a few phrases on the actual journal, and that way it'll fill in kind of any of the gaps that I have in my rainbow, because I want the rainbow to go from the top all the way down. So I have like the red circle sentiment all the way down to the introvert mode label. So I am just building my label, my rainbow, and then I will be able to wrap up this spread. I didn't think I needed any journaling because the journaling is on the actual photo from Instagram. So I'm just going with that. I have this awesome label, like I said, and then I will be nearly done with the spread and I can move on to the next one. Okay, so for this one, I have this cute photo of me outside. Another moment when I was hiding outside, I was just taking a breather and I just wanted to play on my phone and talk to my Instagram friends. So I snapped a photo of myself because I was also proud of myself for conquering the day. But since I was wearing green, one of my favorite shirts and colors, I decided, you know what? I am going to use these gorgeous greenery stamp set and I am going to make a whole 2-page spread to introduce the month of May in my journal and kind of document this day. And I also knew that, I probably said this in the introduction, but I had a bunch of stories from Instagram that I could use for my journaling, which was awesome and helped out so much. I also have my first stamp ink from Close to My Heart, Beth Ann, and it is the fern, so I am using that, and the fern color actually matches my shirt perfectly, so I am just stamping all kinds of phrases from this greenery set, and a few from the gratitude, thankful, grateful, and I'm just going to town, and then I'm gonna fussy cut some stuff out later on. I also have this vellum paper that I absolutely love, and I'm gonna use that for a little bit of black contrast and kind of frame in my journaling and also my photo. I'm gonna go ahead and tear the edges too, just so I can do another texture, another type of texture, and layer that in as well. And then I, like I said, I have grateful and thankful and all of these greeneries to cut out. I also decided to add in a piece of my mixed media paper behind my photo just to add another texture, another layer, some more dimension, and also a brighter green color. So that way the focus is drawn towards my photo as well. Now I'll turn off the camera and fussy cut everything out.
All right, so I am stopping the voiceover, that way I can explain what I did. I cut out all the flowers and I also added in journaling. So I wrote out all of that and I've added 2 pieces here. And like I said, fussy cut a bunch of flowers over here. And now what I'm gonna do is just stamp a few phrases from here or maybe the greenery set. And then I'm gonna finish up this page. All right, I'm gonna get back to it and back to the voiceover. And I did wind up tearing 2 pieces from my mixed media paper. That way, both sides had a little bit of that brighter green. And now I'm stamping some of the word phrases on white piece of paper. I did story and documented, and then I saw that there was so much and feeling, and I thought that that would be perfect for this time right now, so much feeling, because there is a lot of feelings right now. And so I am going to fussy cut those out in a minute, and now I'm going to glue everything down. So my basic design is just some torn paper, different paper textures in the top left corner and the bottom left corner, and then I will have my layering over on the right with my main photo. And then I'm just layering in all of the greenery that I have fussy cut out, and I am just
loving this layout. It came together so beautifully, and I'm just so happy with that. And I'm so glad I have this story documented through Instagram, and now it's on paper. Isn't that the whole point of scrapbooking, is to get those harder stories and all your stories down on paper? So I'm really happy. And that's another reason I love this journal. I've gotten down a lot of stories that I probably wouldn't have documented otherwise. So I'm really happy that I decided to go with this journal and document it from my perspective. Because basically my life is the life that has changed the most since we started the shutdown and kind of adjusting to everything. And so I'm glad I'm documenting my stories during this crazy hectic time. Adding in the last few pieces, and I will be nearly done with this. I have the thankful on the right, grateful down at the bottom, and then I will add in those tiny little words.
Okay, so that is two projects that came together using the brand new releases for Everyday Explorers Company. And I know it was a little bit of a longer process video, but I wanted to show you how I am using all the new stamp sets. And so I wanted to include both this project and this one and in my journal. Just loving this journal, and I am almost finished with putting it together. So I hope you get yourself some new stamps from Christine's shop, Everyday Explorers Co. And I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. I would love a thumbs up or a subscribe if you are new to my channel. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day.